Hey there everyone, Super Easy here, back with Pokémon Red. And I'm going to explore more of this tower. I wonder if these trainers would bow you if you don't have the silk scope. Luckily, abilities don't exist in this game, so I can use ground type moves on them. The problem is if you only have normal type moves, this place is going to be hard. You don't know how hard this place is. If you are doing a Magikarp run, because I have seen videos of people trying to do a Magikarp run and absolutely fail because of this place. Ugh. Oh, a Cubone. I mean, I could catch some Pokemon in here, but I have no use for them in my team right now. In fact, I don't have any. I'm not planning on having them on my team anyway, so. But. Expend Pokeballs. Yes. I'll name him Bonehead. Oh no, we're not learning focus energy. Okay, so I wonder how many Pokemon in my team are useless. Pepper is useless and Sasha is useless. I guess in a way Brussels is also kinda useless. As grass type moves are not gonna be effective against ghost types. Oh, Jesus Christ! This is the last Pokémon Center I used? Oh, come on! Okay, I'm going to use the Poké Center in Lavender Town, so that way the next time I leave the place, I'll be here. Ugh. Oh yeah, that affects Casey. I'll use my last potion. I don't think there's anything up here, right? No. Also, I noticed how different Haunter's cry was back in Generation 1. Oh no. Oh, there we go. Really? Wild Pokemon about right when the trainer's right there. When the trainer is right there, really? PG is evolving! Oh, I guess it's too violent for kids. Well, he evolved into PG-13. A nugget. That's not even a sentence! I think she just makes some random noises. Jesus Christ! What do you have to say? Okay, I know that was not her. Now, here we're facing against Marowak. It's not treated as a ghost type. It's a ground type, like a normal Marowak. But here's the thing about this Marowak is that it's programmed in a way that you cannot catch it. The thing is, as a kid, I tried catching this thing. I tried getting it as low as I could so I could catch it. But I didn't. But it fainted before I even attempted. But it's not like I could catch it anyway. Jesus! Pepper. I need to heal now. Oh no, not now, Pepper. Jeez. One more tap! Ah! Thank you. I'm pretty sure that's exactly what the Japanese would say. Oh, God damn it! Oh, they don't have numbers. Well, that's something. Wait. Okay, there we go. I'll talk about the Pokéflow in next episode. Alright, I'm gonna switch over to Pokémon Yellow. See you there. So, in Pokémon Yellow, instead of the three Rocket Trainers in the top of Pokémon Tower, you fight Jesse and James. And the thing is, all three of their Pokemon are in the late 20s. And the Ekans and Koffing has evolved into Arbok and Weezing. So, I had Tenago on my team, so I could teach it Fly. It took two Flies to take out Meowth. When Jesse sends out Arbok, Arbok used Glare, and I didn't want to waste my time using Fly, because it might be paralyzed mid-flight and just couldn't attack, so I just used Pecs. I just use Peck. And here's the weird thing. For some reason, after Arbok paralyzed me, and I just used Peck, none of the attacks hit me. I don't know if it's a bug or what, but no matter what Arbok did, it just couldn't land a hit. And neither did Weezing. Weezing couldn't even land a hit. Arbok, wait, no, what is Tenago, my Fearow, was paralyzed and didn't get a single hit. I don't know what caused that. I'm pretty certain there's a explanation in Generation 1 that's bugged that kind of explains it. But, wow. So I guess that's all I have to say. If you like the video, please subscribe and have a nice day. See ya.